Taylor Treasures.
Hello!
My sister could not be here today, so we have a special guest.
Hello! Howdy doody!
Bogo Phil.
Yes.
Yes, he is joining us today.
So excited!
Bogo has appeared on this channel before.
Oh yeah,
you're a little familiar. Some of you may be familiar. But can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I surely can. Well, as you said, my name is Bogo Phil, and the reason my name is Bogo Phil is because I like two of everything. You see, I have two bow ties, two suspenders. I love two of everything. I'm a singer. I am a comedian. I'm very famous. I mean, I played in all the biggest arenas with thousands of people. I mean, I'm just huge. I mean, I play everywhere. I'm just an icon in this country of America.
The whole country.
Oh yes. Everybody knows about me. But so I love to perform, and I'm so excited to be here today.
Yeah, well, we're happy to have you, and so are, I guess, the thousands of other people that are apparently, yes. So, could you maybe tell us some of your hobbies? Because we're very interested in you as a person.
So what do you like to do? So I was prepared for this, and I'm going to show you some of my hobbies, and you can help me too.
All right.
So these ones are really fun. You're going to love them. Okay.
All right, let's take a look.
All right, well. So I have some letters here. I have some letters with
cards.
Envelopes. Envelopes. I have more here. So okay. I love to put stamps on letters. Oh my gosh. This is just so fun. I love to do this all the time. And you know what? I have to put out some Christmas cards, so I have to put stamps on anyway. So you want to help me with this? This is some of my hobbies here. Well, you can take some here. Okay. All right, so you got to lick them first, right?
No. Don't lick it.
Why not? Isn't that what you do?
No. These are new ones, so they're already sticky. See? Feel that. See?
Yeah. When did they do that?
While ago.
I've been looking at them for years. They were already sticky. That is genius. Whoever created that. Oh, wow. Wow. Look at how easy that is. Wow. That is just lovely.
So this is what you do for fun, huh?
Oh, this is just so much fun. I love this. Wow. Isn't this a lot of fun?
This is exhilarating.
Oh, see? Oh, we're getting all the work done, and
well,
I don't have to do it later.
Look, you're faster than I am.
Oh, I'm an expert. I've been doing this for... Oh, boy. 57 years in January. Yes.
57.
Oh, yes. I've loved putting letters on all that time. Wow.
All right, you want to do the last one?
Oh, I would be honored. Oh, this is so much fun.
There we go.
Ta-da! Wow.
So that was one of your hobbies. That was a lot of fun.
Love that.
That was very fun.
Putting stamps on letters. I mean, that is just, I love it. Okay, so.
Anything else you like to do?
You ready for my next hobby?
All right.
Okay. This is a goodie. This has to do with my name. Well, all right. I have some coupons. Okay. Now, coupons are wonderful. You save so much money. And I tell my friends this all the time, and they say, it's so much work to find all the good ones. But I say, it is worth it once you get all the deals that you get in these coupons. And so what we're going to do is you're going to take these scissors here and some of these, okay? You're going to take some of those, and I think there's some scissors here. And we're going to go through.
How'd you know those were back there? That's amazing.
So anyways, we're going to be finding the best coupons in here, okay? And we're going to start cutting them out, and we're going to find just the best ones. Oh, and I have to warn you, you might get a little over-exhilarated when you find buy one, get one free. BOGO! That's my name. If you find any of those coupons, that is just jackpot when you find buy one, get one free. So let's look around here.
This is totally exhilarating.
Oh,
totally.
I am having so much fun.
I don't know how.
Wow.
I have never known about this before.
Okay, well, not... Oh, here's the good ones, all right. Oh, well, I've been eating some toothpaste.
Toothpaste?
Buy one. Oh, it was almost buy one, get one. Free, but it's buy one, get one $2. That's just not the same thing. But I'll take it anyways.
Not
I'll take it
the
anyways.
Same.
Ooh, adult gummies. Adult, oh, you need your vitamin C.
I found Play-Doh.
Play-Doh? Wow, that'll be good for some grandkids out there. Loving that. Oh, wow.
Do you have any grandkids, BOGO Phil?
I do not. Not at all.
Not at all.
No.
Not even a little bit do you have grandkids. Not at all.
No, not at all. They're just non-existent in my life, I have to say. The goodies. I found some goodies here. Oreos? Oh my. Oh. Buy one, get one free! I got it! I found one! I got it!
Oh my.
Oh, wow.
Careful there, you're gonna mess it up.
Oh, I got it. Oh, put that in a safe place.
Now, what is that? Do you need that? Whatever that is?
It looks like it's some shampoo for hair that's colored.
So, do you need that?
Oh, what the hey? I'll get it anyways. It's buy one, get one free. You can't miss that. Well, I think we've done enough here for that. That was
very fun. Thank you for sharing.
Oh.
I'm sure that is going to bring so much joy to everyone who now will be cutting coupons.
Oh, yes. Whenever you cut your coupons, just think of BOGO Phil here. BOGO Phil sent you to them coupons.
Well, thank you. So, was that it? Was that all your hobbies you wanted to show us today?
That's about it. That's what I like to do for fun.
Okay.
I love it. All right.
So, next up, BOGO is here, and we thought it might be fun to test BOGO's knowledge of some current slang words that the younger generation is using.
Huh. Okay? I don't know if I've ever heard of slang. What is that?
We're going to just read them off here, and we're going to see if you know what they mean, and if you don't, I will enlighten you.
Alrighty!
So you'll be in with the young kids.
Oh, wow. Okay, I'm ready.
Alright, so how about low-key? What do you think that means?
Low-key. So this is used in a normal sentence? This is what they are?
Yes. This
slang?
Is when you
were
talking, you would use
this. Alright. Well, oh, boy. You know what I think it is? I think it's when the young kids want to be in a band. And there's someone new, and the only way they can get in the band is to say what key they sing and play in. So you come in, and you say, I play in a high key or a low key. And that's it, you know, because I am obviously low. I'm low. So that's what I think it means. You have to say low key to know where you're gonna be in the band. That's right, right?
Not quite. No.
Really?
Low key actually
it
has a few meanings.
Okay.
So you would say it like secretly or like kind of or to some extent. So yeah, you could say it like, oh well, we're doing this low key. Like home renovation project in our office, so it's not like a huge deal, but
it's
not like you're telling everybody, but you're like, it's, you know, it's our low-key project, you know, so you could use it that way.
So it doesn't, it's kind of like okay, you kind of like it, but it's not great. Is that what you're, okay?
Well, or you don't want to spread it all around, you don't want to like put it out there for the whole world to know.
Oh, I see. So, if I found something really exciting, I would say this is really high key, right?
You could just say it's exciting.
Oh, okay. All right.
Okay.
Well,
could also mean like, so, when you like something, but you don't want to admit it. So like I don't know, there's maybe some brand of coffee that everyone's saying is gross and they don't like it. And you're like, well, I kind of low-key enjoy it. That way you don't have to commit to liking it. We can just low-key enjoy it.
So, okay. Alright, well, that was interesting. Learning some new things every day.
Uh-huh.
Alrighty.
Alright, so, how about TBT? What do you think that means?
Tibet?
Well, you don't actually have to spell it out. It's just TBT.
Oh, it's not Tibet. Okay, it's no. T... So each it's letter a, stands for a word, is what you're saying?
It's an acronym, yes.
Okay, alright, well, I got this one. Alright, I know this one. Alright, okay, so, I believe it stands for Tuesday Bingo Tournament.
Maybe it does somewhere, but...
Really, that's... What? It doesn't mean that?
No, I'm sorry, it doesn't. Oh. No, TBT originally meant Throwback Thursday, but it can now be said or used for any day of the week, and it's pretty much just to bring back something that happened in the past. So, like, if you have a picture from 5 years ago, you could say, hashtag TBT, and then the
picture. What's a hashtag? Never heard of that before.
We won't even go there, you know? We'll just not even go there. That's okay.
All right, well. Yeah. Well, I was just thinking that, you know, you have the weekly board in the game room, and you don't want to keep writing Tuesday Bingo Tournament, so you just shorten it, and it's so much easier. That was my logic behind it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, all those bingo nights, I mean, they're crazy, aren't they?
Oh, wow. Some people could get into it.
Yeah.
Well, anyway.
All right, well, anyway, the next one is T. T-E-A.
Doesn't it mean tea?
It does, but it has another meaning in slang word.
Oh, okay. Well, Oh, I know this one. Okay, it's like a code word, okay? So, when you're talking to someone, and they're gonna go to the store for you and get you some stuff, you say, I want you to get me some tea, but really, you want them to get you some lifesaver candy because the person who has you on a diet is standing right behind you and you can't get it. They'll tell you can't have it. So you have to go, I'd like some tea, and then you go, you have to do a wink because or else they will get you tea. So you have to go, I'd like some tea.
So it's two parts.
You have to go and have the wink, and then they'll know, Phil wants some lifesavers.
I feel like this may have happened in your life at some point. You're just so right on about that experience.
Well, you know.
But no, that is not what it means.
Doesn't everybody have that experience? You want some lifesavers and...
You're kind of on the right track.
Okay.
But it means gossip. So if someone could be like, hey, spill the tea. Or,
I see.
Instead of saying spill the beans, it's just gossip.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
That is interesting. Very interesting.
So how about our next one? Ship.
Ship.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it seems as though that is used for the term of something that floats.
That is true, but there's also a different meaning.
Okay. Oh, I know this. It's kind of like the TBT situation going on here. Alright, so, I say it is short for ships passing in the night. The phrase that means, you know, you don't see someone except to say hi and bye because you're both so busy and you say, it's a ship passing in the night, but instead you just say ship.
Huh. Oh, okay. No, not quite.
Really?
No.
I'm not getting any of these.
One is short for the word relationship. So, you know, us young generation, we're always trying to shorten things because we don't like to do things that take a long time. When we speak... like if you wish two people were together, it's normally meant romantically. So you would be like, you know, oh, they're in a ship or they should be in a ship.
Okay.
You can use it as friendship, but you have to kind of specify that it is a friendship and then you have to say the whole word anyway. So,
okay. Well,
yeah,
but that there is you interesting. Go. Yes. Not what I would have thought in a million years. Well, I guess I don't know much modern slang. I guess we're learning here.
Hey, you know what? But now you're going to know it. So when you go to your bingo night, you'll be the cool guy because you'll know all the slang.
I didn't think of that. Yes, Ruth will be so impressed.
Man, Ruth's just going to be amazed.
Yeah. I've been trying for years, telling you.
All right, so our next one is a meme. Do you know what a meme is?
Meme. No, is that spelled M-E-M-E?
M-E-M-E.
M-E-M-E. Huh.
So, it looks like Mimi, but it's meme.
Huh. You know what? I think you just gave me a clue there. I think that meme is two words put together because the kids these days seem to not want to say things fully. So I think meme really means meme, which stands for I want attention, meme over here. Is that what it means? It has to be.
That actually is a pretty good guess, but no. A meme is a popular picture that many different internet users modify and they turn it into a joke. So I will show you an example of a meme.
This is going to be exciting.
So here you go.
Okay.
So you see that says, this is Usain Bolt. You know who that is? He's really fast.
Never heard of him.
Okay, he's really fast. He's like the fastest guy in the world.
Okay.
So these guys are behind, and that's the alphabet, right?
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, and then L, M, N, O, P is in front. Because when people say the alphabet, usually they go A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Like, they say it really fast.
Oh, I see. That's very interesting. Why would that have to be on a picture, though? You could just say, I don't understand completely.
Because it shows you that the LMNOP is in front. It's racing to get past these letters, who are also racing because that's how people say it.
Oh, I see. I don't find the humor in it, but I understand.
Well,
it is now.
That
yes.
is okay. Now you know what a meme is.
Well, I'm glad I know. I've heard some people talk about it these days. Yes.
Yeah. All right. So our the next one is shook. What do you think shook means?
Huh. I'm thinking I know this one.
All right.
I'm very confident. Okay. Well, this needs a little bit of an explanation, but I think I know what it means. It stands for a dog's haircut. All right, hear me out. So, every year I play at the Border Collie event. It's a very popular event. I'm sure you've heard of it. There's many Border Collies there. Something that they do there is they give dogs haircuts for free. And it's a very popular event. So, after they cut the hair, they take the dog and they shake it a little bit to get all the extra hair out. So the dog is shook afterwards. So it's shortened to shook instead of a dog's haircut, right? Oh, I know. This has to be it.
Not quite. No. Shook is kind of like the way you would respond if, like, the way you would react if someone is doing something shocking. Like, if somebody started clawed dancing in the middle of a meeting, you may be shook because that is not expected and you are amazed.
Oh, I get it. So, all right. I get it now. Alrighty, so...
Alright, well, there you go. So that was all our slang words. So, good job. You were close on some
of them. I think I got a lot of them. I think I did,
yeah. And now you can go back and tell Ruth all about your slang words.
Oh, she's gonna be so impressed.
Yes.
I can't wait.
Alright, so next, we have to say it's time for the news, because that's our next segment.
Oh, okay.
Yes, ready? And now it's time for the news! Hello, thanks for joining us. Tonight, I bring you the scoop that Hawaii has just outlawed all mustaches. Please be aware, if you intend to travel there, that upon arriving in the Hawaiian airport, there will be guards armed with razors, and they are not afraid to use them.
Folks, the votes are in! It's official! Bogo Phil's favorite food is Jell-O! There were 3 votes, and although 2 of those votes were mine, it still counts. So remember that when you meet Bogo Phil, his favorite food is Jell-O. Can I go? Oh, good. Go to Hawaii. Alright, Okay, so, I a little surprise for you, okay?
Oh, all right. Surprise for me.
Okay, well.
Oh.
Look, I told you I was a musician. All right, so we're gonna, let's tune up here.
Okay.
Sounds just right, sounds just right. All right, okay. Gonna play a little ditty for you. It's real hard, real nice. All right. Hi, hi, I'm coming down the river and seeing you. Oh, this honey, honey, naughty, naughty.
Yeah. Bogo, that's great. That's awesome. But we actually have to move on. So thank you. But guitar needs to go away for right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. That's so, okay.
I'll see you later.
Later. Now it is time for the Taylor Treasure Box. That is the next thing we're going to do. So can you grab that right over there, that box?
Okay.
All right.
All right. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, so we're going to open this up.
Okay.
And you get to pick out of this box right there.
Oh, you know what? I have an idea. I have a really fun game that I think we should do. Instead of
picking out of the Taylor Treasure Box,
I'm going to take two coupons.
Like that.
Two coupons, and we're going to set them on the table. We're going to mix them around. We're going to mix them around. And now we have to pick one, and whoever gets the best deal wins. Alrighty?
What do we win?
The coupon.
Oh, there's a whole game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Alright. Alright. So, you ready? Okay. Go! Alrighty. Okay. I got... it's called Naked Juice 2 for $6. And I believe it's a healthy smoothie, which... That's pretty good. I mean, I want to stay healthy. What do you get?
Okay, so I got toothpaste and looks like a toothbrush.
Okay.
$3.99, you pay with card. Yeah, and dollar manufacturer's coupon in most Sunday papers. This coupon is involved. Cause then it says, it's like getting it for $2.99 after savings. Plus, buy one, get one, $2 extra bucks reward. There is a lot happening in this little coupon right here.
I think you won. I really
feel like
do.
You get a lot with this coupon, so I'm going to say yes.
Oh, I think you won. Well, congratulations. That was awesome.
Wow.
Oh, yes.
Yes, thank you. That was... Watch your guitar, please. Yes.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Well, I did want to say one more thing.
Okay.
I just want to say I got another acting job, as I always do, and it's on the YouTube channel Bucknell Productions. Now, it's not up yet, but I was in a very, very awesome movie that we filmed over the summer and part of the fall, and they're almost done with it, and I will be on Bucknell Productions' channel, and I am a special guest in their movie/series, so make sure to check that out. Oh, it's really awesome. Yeah.
I'm excited to see Bogo appear.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
boy.
Well, thank you, everyone, for watching. Thank you for being here to listen to Bogo Phil.
Thank you. I had an awesome time. I really did.
Please, make sure to like this video, write us a comment, and hit the subscribe button, and turn on the bell so that you get all the notifications whenever we upload.
Understand a word of that, but do that.
Yes.
Do it. Goodbye! And I'll go
Thank you for watching
you
this episode! Please subscribe!
I have you!
Subscribe if you'd like to watch a previous episode, click down here. And if you want to see a random episode, click down here. And we will see you next Thursday! Bye! Hey guys, one more thing! Sorry, I forgot. The guitar. We're talking really loud. Anyway. Forgot to mention, this is the last episode of season 6. Woo-woo. So we're going to take a break for 2 weeks. We'll be back on the third week with season 7, so don't miss it. But this is the final episode of season 6, and we'll be taking a little break. We'll be back in 3 weeks, so see you then!